Hello, I'm Umar Niazi. I'm a PhD candidate at Gypsy Lab, University of Grenoble Alpes in France. I'm going to present our paper on thermal monitoring of buildings by aggregated temperature estimation. Particularly, we choose the residential buildings. And our choice of working with the residential buildings is motivated by its share in energy consumption and greenhouse gas emissions. Particularly in the outlook of 2013 by International Energy Agency, it was predicted that 14% of worldwide consumption is going to come from the residential sector by 2040. Particularly in France, it's the second largest source of final consumption, coming after the transport sector. In terms of greenhouse gas emissions, it takes a share of 17% of national emissions in France. Now, these figures are quite significant and is the main motivation of working with the residential sectors. However, there are several sources of consumption in residential buildings, but heating takes around 66%. It comes in top and takes 66% of the energy consumption share in France. And this is the main motivation to work with the heating instead of cooling. Now, heating is usually done to attain thermal comfort of inhabitants in residences, which includes that the temperature is in a comfortable range and also humidity level is in a comfortable range. However, what's practical for residences is that it's not affordable to equip sophisticated heaters. And in general, radiators or convectors or other types of heaters are used. The point is that these heaters only heat and they don't have an explicit option to control humidity. Another constraint is that we have limited number of sensors available. We cannot equip the residence with a lot of sensors. So we assume that each heater is equipped with a small sensor, which of course measures its surface temperature. Our contribution includes the design of an observer to estimate aggregated temperature profiles. And these aggregated temperature profiles are chosen to be some kind of measure of thermal comfort. The main hurdle is that we have few sensors available, which could lead that our system is unobservable. Okay? Well, that means that we cannot reconstruct all the state variables of the system. On the controller side, we don't design some kind of controller, but we use a simple on-off controller, which is used generally for temperature regulation. So the controller architecture is given by this block diagram, where we have building with heaters, and on each heater there is a sensor which measures its temperature. Using this sensor measurements, our observer estimates the temperature profiles and compares it with the specified temperature profiles, okay, and operates the controller, which in turn actuates the heaters of the building. So we choose our aggregated temperature profile to be the mean operative temperature of the rooms. And in general, what happens is that the heaters, if they have a feedback mechanism, what they do is they have a sensor which measures the air temperature of the room, and the controller then on-off controller then regulates the temperature based on the air temperature. However, air temperature is not a good measure for thermal comfort, because one, you are measuring at one point of the room and they're regulating the temperature based on that point, but along the room the temperature can vary. Another thing is that the air doesn't have much of the capacitance or much of the thermal mass, which would cause the switching to be very frequent, and it could affect the equipment and also power loss due to chattering, etc. Mean radiant temperature is the average temperature of all surfaces in a room. It includes the internal envelope like walls, ceiling and floor, and internal mass like furniture, carpet. Mean operative temperature combines these two quantities and takes a mean over all the air and all the surfaces in a room. The disadvantage is that it's also an aggregated quantity, so it could ignore the temperature variance along a room. But if you have an average size room, this temperature variance could be negligible. The advantage is that it's a linear quantity, it's mean, and it's an aggregated, which means that it also provides some kind of computational tractability, because now we are dealing with the number of variables which equals the number of rooms instead of all the state variables. Basic principle behind the model is the thermal electrical duality. So where heat flow is analogous to the current flow, temperature difference analogous to the voltage, thermal resistance to electrical resistance, thermal mass to electrical capacitance. The basic elements are then modeled as RC circuit models. Heater is a current source, which is heating the air. Xin is the temperature of the air of a room. Xh is the surface temperature of the heater, which is measured. Internal mass is 2R2C, where we have two resistances and two capacitances. Xm2 is the surface temperature of internal mass. Xm4 is the core temperature of the internal mass. The building envelope, like the walls, ceiling, and floor, are modeled as 3R2C, and Xe2 is the outer surface temperature, Xe4 is the inner surface temperature. We adopt the building setup from the paper by Deng of 2010-2014, where we have four rooms, and three of the rooms have windows, room 1, 2, and 4, and we obtain this RC network model of this building setup, which has 48 nodes. Okay. And these yellow nodes are the heater nodes, green nodes are the air nodes of each room, and all the elements we highlight with different color. So dark gray is the wall between two rooms, light gray is the wall, outer wall of the rooms, blue is the ceiling, brown is floor, and red is the internal mass. Using Kirchhoff's current law, we obtain the model, which has some inputs, and inputs are the heater inputs at the heater nodes, and some inputs which are coming from the outside temperature. And the state-space representation is given by these equations, where we have state X, which is the temperature at the nodes. Q is the heater input plus the outside temperature. Y is the output, which are the measurements at the surfaces of the heaters. And the surfaces of the heaters are modeled as the nodes, yellow nodes here, from 45 to 48. And the state matrix A has a graph structure, which is given here. And it's a bidirected graph because each edge has a different weight in different direction. Okay. So edge ij has weight given by ci rij of inverse, and edge ji has a weight cj rij inverse. Rij is the resistance between two nodes, and ci and cj are the capacitances of each node. On the diagonal entries, we have diffusion terms or the damping terms. Particularly for the nodes which correspond to the air of the rooms which have window, they have an extra diffusion term because the temperature can diffuse out through the windows, and that the resistance, this resistance of the window, is added for that matter. We use the parameter values given in these two papers. First paper, they identify the parameters of the 3R2C model. And the second paper identifies the parameter of the internal mass. And using these parameter values, we would like to do the state estimation and control. The problem statement is given as follows. So given this building setup, and with temperature measurements at the surfaces of the heater and of the outside air, we estimate the mean operating temperature of the rooms, and based on that estimation, we would like to regulate the mean operating temperature of each room. Okay. And mean operating temperature is just the mean of all the room elements, So for example, for each room, there are 8 room elements, and we take the mean of all those elements. So for each room, the elements are highlighted by this dashed line. And then there is an outer envelope nodes, which equal 12. We aggregate this our model and project to a lower dimensional state space, and we call it projected system, which gives the dynamics of the mean operative temperature, and it has a state Z, and Z contains X0, which is the mean temperature of outer envelope, and from X1 to X4 are the mean operative temperature of rooms, and from 45 to 48 is same as the surface temperature of heaters, which are measured. So notice that the output of the projected system equals the output of the original system. Here we have some unknown signal sigma, which is the average deviation vector, and it is in the null space of Q transpose, which is a characteristic matrix of this partition, and is given by as a block diagonal matrix. We divide our system into two systems. One system is the measured subsystem whose state is measured, so A22, and A11 is the subsystem whose state is not measured. This is indicated by the C matrix, the output matrix. And corresponding to this, we have the partition of the projected system matrices, where we aggregate the unmeasured subsystem and keep the measured subsystem as it is. And we use these parameters or these values to design our average state observer. Average state observer is a system whose output is the estimated mean operative temperatures. Okay, so it has a state W, and its input is the output of the system and inputs of the system, and it estimates the mean operative temperature of the rooms. Its matrices are computed using these expressions, where the only unknown is the V matrix, which is our design matrix. Okay, we choose this V matrix in order to obtain some kind of desirable performance. So estimation error is the mean operative temperature minus the estimated mean operative temperature, and it satisfies this equation where we parameterize n matrix of the observer by V, because this is an unknown matrix and we would like to find the best possible V matrix. Okay. Analyzing this equation, we then postulate our theorem, which says that the estimation error converges to zero exponentially at an arbitrary rate. We can choose whatever rate we want by choosing V matrix, if and only if this rank condition is satisfied. Now, what this rank condition says is that it requires that each heater node is directly connected with all the thermal elements of the respective room. However, this condition is restrictive and is not satisfied in our building setup, because our heater node is not directly connected to the wall or the ceiling. It's connected to the wall through the air of the room, okay? So the node that represents the air of the room. So what we do is we would like to now minimize this estimation error as best as we can. So first we realize that this estimation error equation is influenced by an exogenous signal. And first we would like to find the value of this design matrix V such that the norm of this exogenous signal is minimum. And for that we have an explicit solution that this norm is minimum for this value of V, and we call it V star. And this is constant because it depends on the parameters of the projected system. However, this value of V doesn't ensure that this estimation error is small, because this is just minimizing the external signal. But it may happen that this matrix for this value of V is not curved. Okay? We perturb this solution by some alpha, which is a scalar greater than zero. And then now we have a parameterization on alpha instead of V, and we write this error equation, and we would like to find alpha such that n alpha fq is Hurwitz. and that this proposition says that there exists some value alpha prime such that if we choose alpha to be greater than alpha prime, and alpha f2 is always Hurwitz. Okay. Now we have a convex optimization problem where we write the asymptotic value of the estimation error, which is the norm of some disconvolution, the limit. And using Young's inequality, we split this into psi alpha and sigma infinity norm. This sigma infinity norm is some constant, and we would like to minimize the psi alpha by choosing an appropriate alpha value. Appropriate, I mean that alpha should be such that n alpha fq is Hurwitz. To find alpha, we have this simple algorithm to find for convex optimization. So we increment alpha by epsilon until n alpha fq is Hurwitz, and when it is Hurwitz, we keep on increasing alpha by epsilon until our cost is decreasing. Okay, so that at the moment the cost increases, we take this point and find the global optimum value between these two points. In the results, we reiterate our goal. Our goal is to maintain the mean operative temperature in the range of 20 to 22 degrees Celsius, and the controller is operating on the estimated mean operative temperature. So if your estimated mean operative temperature is less than 20, the heater turns on and it keeps on until the estimated temperature crosses the 22 degrees Celsius limit. And it turns off and it keeps off until the first condition is again satisfied, okay? So in between, it follows this principle. So the results show that the solid black line is the original mean operative temperature, and dotted red line is the estimated mean operative temperature. And the controller shows that it's operating on this dotted red line. Okay? Since our estimation is an optimal estimation with the minimum error, we see that also the original mean operative temperature is also regulated inside the 20-22 range. In terms of percentage estimation error for the optimal alpha, we have around 3% on average. But if you choose alpha to something else, the error increases a lot. In conclusion, we show that the mean operative temperature is a good measure for thermal comfort. It also provides computational tractability because it's an aggregated quantity. And then we design an average state observer to estimate this mean operative temperature, and we do it in an optimal manner via convex optimization such that the estimation error is as small as possible. And then we design our on-off controller, which takes feedback from this average state observer and then regulates the mean operative temperature based on the estimation. In future, we would like to focus more on our controller in order to minimize energy consumption and also minimize the temperature variance along the rooms. For the observer, we'd like to embed an algorithm to do parameter identification online. Since now we are using constant parameters, but the parameters could differ from building to building. So it would be really great if we can embed it in an online manner. Thank you.